Glory, glory, hallelujah, and welcome to Drive Time. My name is Vernon Howe. You're listening to and watching episode 19B. Yes, that's right, 19 little guys with each of their own little tentacles springing out exist into the world. Something like 60 of these. Whoa. I have an idea for a company that would build websites for free, and then the catch would be, we'll build it free if you like it, you buy it, we'll implement it, and get all of the shit going for you, and then hopefully get on a subscription plan up to $500 a month. And at that level, it would be, you know, I would only have to get about, you know, 5 to 10 companies at that main level, and I could, keep going forward. I mean, honestly, I think I could easily do that, and it wouldn't take up a lot of my time. And that would be a company. It'd be a media company, and I would create, you know, graphics. It'd be different levels, maybe even like $1,000 a month. At that level, and it sounds like a lot to be paid for that, but if you think about it, it's really less than you pay an employee, and essentially I'd be working for you, for them. I don't know. It's doable. I want to put the company together fast, because I know if I can put the company together fast, then I know that doing the company will be fast. Does that make sense? I want to turn around the company in like 2 days. I want to get it from nothing to you know. And I'm working on ideas kind of loosely right now. And a lot of the loose ideas are based around like what would be the name of the company and what would my own branding of the logo of the company look like. Because I want to get, I there's no room for error there, in my opinion. That has to be good. That has to be okay with that. That can't be really changed later in the process. So that has to be good. And then you know, once that's perfect, and I thought of a couple that are taken. You know, naming a company. Once I name the company, know there's a URL out there I can grab for $8. Then it's on. Then it's just a matter of, okay, from this point forward, build it, and then see what you can do. You see what you can make of this company, and the point of when I you know, I get excited thinking about this is because it would afford me the free time. Essentially, I could get paid, live and work and do what I wanted and create my own schedule, but I would be making a living, and I wouldn't have to worry about health benefits because I could get on. My wife has an excellent plan I can hop onto, and. So yeah, that's, you know, starting one's own company. I'm based on that premise, and I have time right now that I can do it. And it's a matter of if a company says yes, build me a website, and I build it, and I turn it around, and it's not what they're looking for, then I've wasted that time. And that's the you know, if that happens, if that turns out to be the case. See, I don't know. I have to assume that. Even if I worked at a 50%, based on how much time it does take to create that initial website, how many no's could I handle? What tier would I need people to start signing up for? Because I assume the opening of the door is going to be easy in a way. If you're a small business, and I'm going to be targeting small businesses in the area, but then, you know, potentially anywhere in the country. Why wouldn't you take that chance? And the overhead cost of running these websites is free. I mean, you'd be using, you know, free services and just paying for the domains. And in certain cases, the domains won't even need to be bought. they just might need to be transferred. If it's a company that already owns the domain, they just need to give me the information, and I can go in and transfer over the URL. It's daunting. There's a lot of work involved, but I think if the setup takes me, if setting up a company is only going to take me like maybe a week, then I can do it, because then I think, you know, once I've set it up, my own company, and I'm ready to go, and there's no overhead. There's like literally no overhead for this company. I would buy probably a new computer if and when I was ready to full-fledged go into it and start working from home full-time. You know, it's an idea I've had for a while, but now I'm trying to make it take, because I have to fix something. I have to fix this not wanting to, you know, be at my job. But, you know, it could be worse, and I understand that, and I don't have it bad. But did I talk about the 0 for 4 analogy? Maybe I'll do that on coming back from lunch. Because that was an interesting kind of thing I thought of. So look for that in episode 19C. Thanks for listening.